students, welcome back with a new chapter. I hope you all are doing well. So, today we are going to study about chapter 2, that is Symbols of National Identity. Students, every independent nation in the world has its own national symbols, like we say national anthem, national emblem, yes, and national song. So today we'll study about each of it. So let us study about, first of all, the introduction of the chapter, that there are so many countries in the world that it has its own national symbol. But every country has its own national symbol. As you can see over here, the world of the flags, it has a symbol of it. The main national symbol of India are the national flag, national emblem, and national anthem. So, you will be studying each of them in a detail, that national song, national tree, national animal, national bird, national flower, and national fruit. Let's study the first topic of national flag. So students, the national flag of India is tricolor. Yes, so it is popularly called as Tiranga. And we feel proud to see our national flag being hoisted on special day like Independence Day and Republic Day. Students, remember, this is the national flag of India. Now let us study detail in it. Now there are three horizontal bands and it has an equal size of it. The first band is saffron. It stands for courage and sacrifice. And the second band is white. It stands for truth and peace. At the center, you can see over here, there is a spoke. Of the white band, there is a navy blue wheel. What do you see this? It is a navy blue wheel with 24 spokes. You can see over here, there is a line going on. So that is known as 24 spokes in a wheel and is known as Ashoka Chakra. So this stands for righteousness. And the third band, that is green, stands for growth and prosperity of the land. So students, this was about the national flag. Now let's read about national emblem. National emblem can be commonly seen on the coins as well in the rupees. Yes, when you buy something, when you just see the coins, there'll be a national emblem. Yeah, so just see it off. In the emblem, we can see three lions facing different direction. But students, on the either side of the wheel, there is a bull and a horse. But the fourth lion is hidden, yeah, from the view. When you see, the fourth lion is hidden. Only you can see is the three lions that are facing with a different direction. And on the either side of wheel, there is a bull and a horse. Okay, over here you can see bull and a horse. So the word that is Satyame Jayate means what? It means truth alone wins, and it is written below. Okay, here it does not mean written, but it is written down below of the emblem. What does students Satyame Jayate means? It is an important word. You should know it. What does it mean? It means truth alone wins. And it is written below of the emblem. Let's talk about national anthem. Now students, as you know in your school, yes, you have sung about Jana Gana Mana. Yes, and that is what? That is your national anthem. Yeah. So it is composed by whom? It is composed by the great poet Rabindranath Tagore. And it was first sung on 27 December 1911. Again, it may ask you in your MCQ, okay, when it was first sung on 27 December 1911, who was the poet, Who composed it? Rabindranath Tagore. You'll remember. Yes? Yeah. Very good. Now, when you listen or sing the national anthem, what you should do? You should stand in attention position and show our respect. Okay? So, this is what we read about national anthem. Now, let us talk about national song. Our national song is Vande Mataram, and it was written by Sri Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay, and it was sung to show respect to our motherland. Let's talk about national animal. So, national animal. Okay, the national animal of India is who, students? Yes, tiger. So, it is a majestic animal and it shows courage. Yes, so but tigers are endangered animals. Their homes are getting destroyed by the human population. Okay, and you know, students, even there is a Project Tiger. Do you know why it is being said it is Project Tiger? Because nowadays tigers are being decreased of. Okay, so the government has used to implement it as, say, the Project Tiger. So they are also hunted and killed. The government of India has started Project Tiger to save the national animal. So now government what has started off? Because as tigers have been killed and hunted, so as to save them, they had put in a project as a Project Tiger. National bird. Now, the national bird of India is, what you can see on the screen? Yes, peacock. And what it shows? What do you feel when you see peacock? You feel glad. No, you want to see peacock. Yes. So when you see peacock, it shows us about beauty and joy. Yes. So it is very colorful bird and it is highly valued in India. It helps the farmer get rid of insects and snakes. Let's talk about national tree, students. Do you know which is our national tree? Yes, correct. The national tree of India is banyan tree. See, you have seen over here on the screen. So, it is also called as Indian fig tree. What is also known as banyan tree as? Indian fig tree. And it grows over a very large area. Yes, it needs a large area. Why? Because the root gives rise to more trunks and branches. So, it has a very long life. Yes, because it root give rise to trunks as well as branches. And it is considered very sacred. What is the meaning of sacred, students? Yes, very good. Holy. And the last topic is national flower, that is lotus. So, the national flower of India, students, what? Yes, lotus. And what also you can see as, it is also known as water lily, as it grows in water. What you remember as a lotus as? Water lily. Why? Because it grows in water. It is beautiful flower with many petals. These are called petals. Okay, and it has a long stem. So it is regarded as very pure and sacred. Again, what is the meaning of sacred, students? Holy. And the last is national fruit. Okay, students, which is your national, which is the national fruit of India? Yes, mango. Do you like to have this fruit? Yes, you wait for it. No, for the season when mango, it's season of mango. Yes, and it's juicy and delicious fruits. Yes, so it is a rich source of vitamins A, C and D. There are many varieties of mangoes in different size, colors and shape. So students, I hope your concept is clear and understood. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.